Hi everyone, in today's video...
Hi everyone! In today's video, we'll be optimizing a 3D prop pack for Unreal Engine. I'll walk you through the process from basic to advanced techniques, ensuring your models perform flawlessly in your projects. Hey, if you want to grab this prop pack, just scan the QR code on a screen, or hit up the link in the description. We've got some cool stuff in there designed for all sorts of scenes in Unreal Engine, just for you.
Optimizing your models is essential for maintaining high performance in Unreal Engine, especially in complex scenes.
Let's take one of the props from the Alehouse pack. This axe will do. I'll show you two methods to optimize its textures. First, left-click on the axe to open it. Then open the material instance and each texture map within it. As you can see in the Details tab, this texture is imported at 4K, along with other texture maps. However, for rendering display, the maximum for this game is set to 1K for the normal map, 256 by 256 for ambient occlusion, roughness, and metal maps, and 2K for the base color. You might think 256 is too low, but trust me, it doesn't significantly impact the visual quality. To do this, in the Details tab, search for Size and set the maximum texture size to the values mentioned. Save each texture separately. Now, if you have a lot of textures, there's a more efficient way. Locate your texture folder. For instance, this prop pack has 294 textures. Select all the textures you want to resize, right-click. Go to Asset Actions and click Edit Selection in Property Matrix. In the Property Matrix, search for Size in the pinned columns and adjust all selected textures simultaneously. Finally, save your changes. Notice the performance difference with optimized textures, ensuring top performance without sacrificing visual quality. Configuring LODs for optimal performance. Now, let's set up our LODs correctly based on Epic Games' recommended settings. Open one of the assets we imported and select the LOD option. It's suggested to have 4 LODs for standard props to ensure smooth blending with minimal cost. Using the small prop preset will automatically configure these LODs for us. Manual LOD distance setup, you'll see 4 different LODs in the drop-down menu. To optimize, disable the auto-compute LOD distance feature, even though it usually does a good job. Set the following distances. For LOD 0, use 1. For LOD 1, use 0.1. For LOD 2, use 0.05. And for LOD 3, use 0.01. Remember, LOD numbers start at 0. Copying LOD settings to other meshes. To save time, you can copy these LOD settings to other meshes. Right-click the asset in the content browser, select Copy LOD Settings, then paste these settings to your other meshes. This ensures consistency across all assets. Testing LOD Transitions. To verify the LODs are set up correctly, test the transitions in the asset viewer by moving closer to and away from the mesh. This will show the LOD changes as the screen size varies, reducing the poly count effectively.